What standard are you going to sing?
Someone to Watch Over Me.
Very nice. Yeah. I would love to hear
it. Okay. Someone to Watch Over Me. It's a song that my mom always sang all the time. So when I saw that on the list, I was like, I want to do that song because I kind of already knew it and I love it.
I'm a little lamb who's lost in the wild.
Someone to Watch Over Me is a perfect song. And you don't have to do much to it. There's a little turnaround at the end when you go, over me, right? And then you sang a lick after that. And I have no idea why you did that.
You don't like that?
No, because it's silly. It doesn't mean anything. My advice to you would be don't sing notes that are not in the chords.
Harry was definitely right. It's just more powerful just holding out the note. So definitely gonna do that.
That's great, Angie. Congratulations, nice work.
Thanks. This song will be for my mom, for the many times that she's sang it around the house. This is for you, Mom.
Okay, let me stop you. What are you singing about? Like, tell me what this tune is about in two sentences.
A guy who I guess they're being really, like, funny and weird.
To be perfectly truthful, she had no idea what that song was about. What's the next line?
Your looks are laughable.
What does that mean?
He looks funny.
He's ugly.
Like, oh, okay. Oh.
Yeah. What's the first line of the bridge?
Is your figure less than Greek?
What does that mean?
Is your figure, or the way you are, is it less than Greek?
What is Greek? What are we talking about? You need some help?
I do.
It's very difficult to be critiqued one-on-one. It's embarrassing for somebody to say, you don't know what you're singing about. I admire Amber's ability to take the critiques in a very elegant way. Make sure that when you get back, you look up Lorenz Hart, who wrote these lyrics. He had some serious self-confidence issues. I'm not a psychiatrist, but I think that these lyrics may have reflected some things that he felt about himself. You have to know what you're singing about, and you can see it change in her when she started singing. You can see her become aware of what those lyrics meant. You're perfect in your imperfection. And if she sings it like that, I think she'd be great, really, really great.
All right, welcome back to American Idol. We're in the middle of round two, and Harry Connick Jr. helping us out as our mentor this evening. And compared to the current songs earlier, are the standards more challenging? What do you think?
I love when singers sing runs. I know some really great singers like Kim Burrell, Mariah, people who really can sing runs. The standards that they're singing do not need them. I told all four of them, in my opinion, sing it. Right. And I don't think you need... There's a reason those songs are standards and why they've lasted so long. For me, sing the melody. Hitting high notes at the end of My Funny Valentine doesn't make any sense.
Right.
I love Amber. I think she's amazing and she's going to be a big star. But I disagree with
that.
No, I don't think so.
Well, let's see how it went with Candace, part two, right here with Harry. Watch.
I'm singing You Change by Billie Holiday. You change. It's a very emotional song.
That sparkle in your eye.
In a relationship, I think the worst feeling that you can get is when you look at the person and you realize that they're drifting away from you. I would sing it like the tune is. Just sing it. And think about that guy or that girl or whoever you're thinking about. If you said, you've changed, the sparkle in your eyes gone. You know, just sing the lyric. Keep going.
Your kisses are now so blasé.
I just have to think about the lyrics and really, really connect to the song.
The way you just sang it, man, it's smoking. Now, maybe some of the 14-year-olds in the audience won't get it, but I would be willing to take that risk. I just wanted her to know it's more important for her to sing the melody and really mean the lyrics than try to go off and try to make it something that it's not.
Give each other a hug.
If you like.
Yeah, I'd rather not. Can I have a cup of coffee, please?
Thank you.
Thanks, Candace.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, really nice.
Thank you.
I'm singing Stormy Weather for my standard song.
There's so many different versions of it.
Millions.
So I tried to...
Who'd you listen to?
Lena Horne, Etta James. I grew up with Etta James, so that one I kind of knew more of.
Mm-hmm.
Don't know why There's no sun up in the sky. Stormy weather. Since my man and I ain't together.
If you sing simply, it can be very, very powerful.
Okay.
You don't need any of those licks that you're singing for two reasons. One, they're gratuitous, and two, that I'm gonna be honest with you, they're wrong. They asked me to be a mentor, so I'm gonna give them everything I have, but I'm not gonna come up here and blow smoke. I'm gonna tell them, you know, you asked me, I'm gonna tell you. What you're doing is you're taking the melody away from the tune, and the reason this is such a great song is because of the melody. I mean, check it out. You learn. I mean, can we get it? But what are you singing about? I mean, look at the lyrics. As you go, as soon as you go like this, walk in the sun once more. Watch this when you go, woo! Everybody's like, wait, what are we clapping for? This girl's like in the throes of depression. Like, what are we? That makes no sense to me.
Yeah.
That makes no sense. What kind of singer do you want to be? Do you want to be a great singer?
Yes.
Then sing the song and screw all of that house getting stuff.
What version is your?
It's the song.
What version is your like Matt?
I would listen to Lena because
okay.
She's the first person to sing it.
Creed picked a tough one. People may not think so, but that's a tough song.
You have a freaking great voice. My wife loves you. She'll say that girl can really sing. So sing it. You know what I'm saying? Don't know why there's no sun up in the sky, stormy weather. Sing that son of a gun.
For Creed to really learn the melody and why the melody works like it does in a few days is next to impossible. Can she do it well enough for the show? Heck yeah.
You know, me knowing a little bit about you over this time, over all of these months now on the show, I think that probably the disconnect between you, Harry, the song, the whole thing, because we're all saying basically the same thing. I don't have a whole lot to add, but knowing you, you probably would have chose the Etta version, which was more bluesy than the Lena version. So always stick to who you are. What you learn, anything on this show, is who you are. So you know what I'm saying? But I think you still did a good job.
Great. Well, Harry, do you want to have a minute to respond? I feel like we owe you a minute.
Manny, you just said choose the Etta version versus the Lena version. Okay.
I'm holding Keith Urban's hand.
Okay.
So you were talking about individuality and singing it your way, and you just said you should have chosen the Etta James version. You're telling them to sing it like Etta James.
No,
you sing
know
it
why?
Like
you know
have
why?
To know the song. You have to know the melody.
You know
first.
Why I say that? This girl is like a bluesy, country, soulful singer.
I agree.
That is exactly what Etta James is.
But
that would be closer for her to hear.
But Randy, she has to learn the melodies first.
I agree.
You're talking about song choice. This was written by the same guy who wrote Somewhere Over the Rainbow. One of the greatest American composers of all time. You have to learn the song first and then be Creed. But you
I
have
agree.
To learn it.
I agree, but Creed, always just be you, baby.
Yeah.
Don't get inside your head when you're thinking about who should I be. We want you to be Creed. That's all we're interested in.
Nothing like a healthy debate.
That's all we
right?
want is you.
We want you to be Creed, but choose the Etta James version.
Yes. Because Creed is closer to Etta than
Randy,
James.
Randy, stop.
Listen.
Stop.
Listen.
She is.
You're making Nikki and Mariah look very benign here in terms of the dynamic. Would you relax?
What?